Welcome to episode number 52 of the Five Letters Podcast. We got myself Yells, we got Bez, we got Cam. Let's get into it. The Five Letters Podcast. Yes, yes. So we're here. Boys, what's up? Talk to me. How are you guys doing?
Yeah, doing good, doing good.
Yeah, I'm all right still.
Yeah, so it's been, you know, another 2 weeks. What you been up to? How's life? How's things?
Yeah, it's been good. 2 weeks have been good because I've been off work for the last week. Well, last week before last.
Life.
Yeah, man, living that bum life. Like, it was nice. It was nice to not be working. And yeah, been to the cinema a couple times and just been chilling and stuff. So yeah, it's been good, been chill.
Vibes. Cam, what about you?
Obviously, same really, because obviously I'm not working no more either. So I've just been chilling, just been streaming.
Jeez.
Trying to just get back into my coding stuff as well.
Yeah.
Get some work done.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, it's been pretty much the same for me as well. I had last week off. I'm going back to work next week and I'm gutted. but I've just been literally just, I guess Cam's been streaming. I've just been like making TikTok videos and various other things, getting into my content creator bag. So yeah, that's how it's been for us. So let's get into our first song of the episode. And on the flip side, we might have a little bit of a cheeky surprise for you.
got a secret.
yeah, gotta keep it hush for now. But yeah, let's get into That Girl by Bree, Runway.
Been that girl. Been that girl. Been that girl. Been that girl. I already been that girl. I already been that girl. Get the cash, get the money, but it's been that girl. If you bad, then you know it, better show up, girl. I already been that girl. Been that girl, get the cash, get the money, but it's been that girl. If you bad, then you know it, better show up, girl. I already been that girl, get the cash, get the money, but it's been that girl. If you bad, then you know it, better show up, girl. Get your ass on the runway, it's a whole new world. Speechless, he don't know what to say. My body look good in that new Gaultier. Switch up the swag 4 times in a day.
And we're back. That was That Girl by Bree, Runway. What are you lot thinking of that one? That's right.
Yeah, sounds good.
Man, that song was, I was feeling it.
Yeah, so we have a very, 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 very special guest in the building. In fact, so Bez, do you want to do the honors? Go for it, man.
Yeah, go on. And so we've got the one, the only, Denise. it's Janinne, my sister Janinne. How you doing, Janinne?
Hello. I'd like to get closer. Hello. I'm so happy and honoured to be on you lot's show. Hello. I'm going to try and not embarrass Sabez and try and not get you lot cancelled.
Okay? We'd appreciate that very much.
How's your 2 weeks been, Janinne? Last 2 weeks?
To be honest, the last 2 weeks, I feel like, do you want to hear about August?
Go for it.
Okay, cool. August was really fun. I had a lot of fun in August. It was a lot of partying, a lot of work as well, but it was like work-related partying as well. So it was really fun.
We loved that.
But then I feel like I felt a bit behind in life because I was so out. So now the last 2 weeks, I've been just like getting back into the flow of my routines and of life and trying to be on top of like my house, my work, my clients, stuff like that, basically, you know, just, yeah.
Okay. So when you say clients, let's actually introduce you. Yeah, what clients do you have?
I'm a prostitute. I'm joking.
Whoa.
I'm joking.
She's not really my sister. This is Denise.
I'm joking. I'm a tattoo artist. I've been a tattoo artist for years. So yeah, I'm a tattoo artist.
Mad. Before we get into that, we're going to get into that even more, but I think I forgot to mention that this is our official 2-year anniversary show as well.
Congratulations,
so,
guys.
Yeah, a quick round of applause. Woo. Yeah, we've hit a lot of milestones recently. So yeah, I just wanted to make sure that was said. But yeah, tattoos, like, talk to us. Well, I guess we can all kind of talk about it because, as you all know, I hate tattoos. I have a passion against tattoos. Now joking.
I was like, I never knew that. I thought you were just like, you're not going to get one for yourself.
Yeah, joking. It's definitely not that extreme, but I just don't particularly see myself having tattoos.
Yeah.
But obviously Cam has tattoos, Bez has tattoos, Did you tattoo Bez?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, I've done one tattoo on you. We did it two separate.
Two sessions, but it's like one big tattoo.
Yeah, yeah. So Bez has one quite big tattoo. It's like his wrist to his elbow, basically. Yeah.
Oh, fun, fun. Right, so how did you get into tattooing? When did you start?
To be totally, totally honest, do you want to hear the real story or the scripted story?
Tell us the scripted story first, and then the real one.
I've always been into art, and naturally the...
Even the voice when you're telling me is like scripted.
I've always been into art.
It's not my normal voice. So yeah, the scripted story is I've always been into art, and the next natural progression for me was to become a tattoo artist.
Mm-hmm.
That's the story I'm meant to tell people, the scripted story. The real story is I went to get a little heart on my leg, which was literally like smaller than a 5p even. But when I went into the studio to get it done, they quoted me £40 to get a little heart, which is like the size of a dot. My shot minimum is £50 or £60. So yeah, that was a shot minimum, £40. So I thought, you know what? I'm going to do it myself. So I went and got a kit. And when I got a kit, all my friends were like, oh my God, you're a tattoo artist now. Tattoo me, tattoo me. So like, that's literally how I became a tattoo artist. What's it called? Demand by demand. What's the, I don't know what the word exactly.
By demand.
Yeah, something like that. Yeah.
Fair enough, fair enough. Like that's how a lot of people, like great things happen, is like you just start it and then somewhere down the line you just look back and you're like, oh, I'm actually like, this is what I do now. Like
it's crazy. I did always have it on my bucket list, like before I started tattooing. I don't know if I ever told Sebez this, but I've always...
Honestly, even told me the story of how you got into tattooing.
Really?
I think so.
The first time you ever heard it?
Pretty much. I'm pretty sure it is, yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah, I always had it on my bucket list to do a tattoo on someone. Like, you know when people be like, I want to go bungee jumping or I want to skydive or whatever. I always had the thought that one day I do want to, like, tattoo someone. But it's crazy to think now I've probably tattooed over, like, 1,000 people. Like,
that's wild. You ticked off, like, 1,000 times.
I know.
Do you ever get, like, the urge to just mess up someone? The reason why I say this is because, all right, so part of the reason why I say I would probably never get a tattoo is because I'm very much of the opinion of I don't know how I feel, but if I get something, I don't know how I feel about it later in life, and especially because I can't think of anything that I would want on me permanently. So I'm like, why would I get something that I'm kind of okay about now, and then 10, 15, 20 years down the line, I'm like, I hate this. So then I asked that because I'm like, I feel like I'm a bit evil as well. I feel like if I was a tattoo artist and I was doing it, I would always be fighting back the urge to just...
do whatever you want on people.
Yeah.
Well, to answer your first... well, to come back to your first comment, like where you might change your mind. To be honest, when you have a tattoo, can you guys think it as well? You kind of forget it's there.
Yeah.
You don't really think about it, you know?
Yeah, like... all the time I'll look at mine and be like, oh yeah, that's there. And I'm like, I don't really care that it's there, but it's there.
You forget about it. So I've had some tattoos on me since I was 18, so about 12 years. And the odd time I might look at it and wish I could put something better there, but I don't ever wish I had nothing there, if that makes sense.
Okay, no, I get that.
And the messing up people thing...
you're about to say, yeah, I do that every day.
No, there's different levels of messing up because with tattoos, you can kind of always go over it and there's always a way to fix it. But there is some people that do come in with real attitude, really stubborn. They're not willing to compromise or work on anything. So you think, you know what, I'm just going to give you what you deserve. But then at the same time, you do have to try and remain professional. I think
of course.
Most mess ups are accidental, to be honest.
No, that's fair enough. That's fair enough.
Yeah.
Before we actually get any further, let's actually shout out your Instagram. Because you've got some... No, I know. Go for it.
My Instagram?
Yes.
So it's Janinne. Do I have to do the J for Juliet, A for Alpha, N for November?
Your name is spelled different, so you
can share. Okay, yes. Okay, cool. So it's J-A-N-I... Oh, God.
N-N-E.
Maybe forget how to spell my name. J-A-N-I-N-N-E. The T-H-E, creator, C-R-E-A-T-O-R. Janinne the creator.
Yeah, Janinne the creator. Go look at her Instagram page. There's some pieces on there. It's absolutely crazy. Go check it out.
Thank you.
But yeah, wanted to shout out before we get too deep in and start forgetting about things. So definitely wanted to do
like
that.
Like my name.
I know. It's bad with me.
Oh, man. So have you, in terms of tattooing and stuff, what do your parents think about that? I just really, really controversial question.
That is a good question.
Have you heard the answers? Do you know? So again, you didn't know how I got into this. Do you know what mum and dad think about it?
I don't know what dad thinks. I'm sure I'm pretty sure I can guess what mum thinks.
I don't really know what dad thinks either, to be honest. When I started getting tattoos, he didn't like it. He said, again, like what you were saying. Am I going to like it forever? Am I going to be happy? Am I going to change my mind when I'm 30? Which, like we were saying, you forget about it. But so my dad's really quite an easygoing. He's not really a strict, dominant father. Wouldn't you agree, Sabez? He's quite a laid-back dad.
Yeah.
Our mum's the more dominant one. And she really had dreams of me being a doctor. Do you remember this?
Yep.
Yeah, it was literally...
Well, you're kind of operating on people.
You should tell, you said to her.
You know, I'm kind of there. So like...
Just a skin doctor, innit?
You know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know?
You wear Crocs now and everything.
I do. I love the... Shout out Crocs. I love Crocs. Everyone in the world get a pair of Crocs. But yeah, so my mum did want me to be a doctor, like a... actual medical... You know how African... Mm-hmm. Not even just African, I guess. All ethnic parents kind of have... You be a lawyer, you be a doctor, or... What's the other one? There's one more. Lawyer, doctor, and there's another good job they want you to have. Well, yeah, one of those three anyway.
We're all like, I don't know.
Podcaster.
Podcaster, yeah. So, yeah. So, yeah, my mum was a bit upset and she was like, oh, you're just, you know, running away. And because I've always been a bit of a free spirit is a good way to put it. So she thought I was just throwing my life down the pan again in another way. But when I told her how much tattoo artists can actually make per day, she was like, wow, yeah, go do that, do that. So she's happy now. Yeah, as long as that, she's kind of like, as long as you're happy, Janinne, and you're doing something that makes you happy, go for it. Yeah, so she's very happy now. Yeah,
no, love that. Obviously we always love a parent that understands, at least in some way.
What did she say when you got your tattoos?
When I got my tattoos?
Yeah, because okay. I know she wasn't very pleased when you did mine. But
so Sabez was very honest with our mum and said, I'm getting a tattoo by Janinne. And my mum said, So it's like, I'm getting it tomorrow. And my mum said, literally gave my mum the whole countdown until the day he got it. And he came home with it and said...
Because I knew, like, if I said it once, she pretended she didn't know. So like, I said, like, I'm getting a tattoo. Janine's tattooing me next week. Janine's tattooing me, like, 3 days. And she, even when I told her, like, Janine's tattooing me tomorrow, she's like, what? What do you mean Janine's tattooing you tomorrow?
Do you know what? That kind of reminds me. When I was 22 or however old, when I cut my locks off, I did a similar thing with my parents. I was like, yeah, Cam's going to, like, cut my hair. Like, you know.
You brought Cam into it as well.
Well, he did it.
Yeah, I mean, I had to do it. Yeah, because, I mean, it's easiest for me to cut it in our house, and then he goes to the barbers to get it cleaned up.
Yeah. Because, yeah, like, if you go to the barbers, like, they're going to be like, what?
Why didn't you just say, I'm cutting my locks off, mum and dad? Why did you have to incriminate Cam with you?
you did mine, didn't you? You cut mine off for me.
Oh,
I did, actually. I did. Yeah.
So did you snitch first? Is that why? Was it payback?
No, I think it just, like, we didn't plan for him to do it for me. It just happened on the day.
Yeah.
And then my other brother took me to the barbers to get it cleaned up.
But yeah, no, it was just saying this is what's happening, and because he was gonna do it, I just said he was gonna do it. My mum was kind of like, okay, but that's how my mum is. She'll be like, okay, but inside she, you know, internally screaming.
Yeah. I think that is mum's, isn't it? Yeah.
And then my dad took it a bit more personally, but hey,
yeah,
it is what it is. But yeah, so you were saying, Bez, that your mum... You were counting down for your mum.
Yeah, and she wasn't...
In denial.
Yeah, basically she was in denial. She wasn't accepting it. And then when I did, even that day before, I said to her, she was still a bit like, you're getting a tattoo? You're doing what? And then, like, obviously I got it done, went home, and it was, had the cling film around it. And she was like, let me see. Obviously she was in this whole time. And then now I'm home, she's like, let me see. And then I showed it to her.
At first you was like, no.
Yeah, but I was like, no, you didn't want to see, you didn't care. So why do you want to see now? And then I show it to her, and then she's like pretending not to look. She's there like, let me see, what even is it?
But so what I did with the tattoos, did I interrupt? Is that okay?
No, go for it.
All right, cool. So what I did with my tattoos was I would get it and then hide it for a year. So I would literally be in like...
What do you mean would? What do you mean would?
I would.
Janinne got like a couple tattoos like 2 weeks ago. Or like, how long ago was the create and attract ones?
No, that was like about a month ago, I think. Maybe
it was more than a month. It was like probably like, you were like 6 months ago maybe.
Yeah.
And I think mum didn't notice them until like last month or something.
No, until like last week. Literally. Because
she's like, yeah, I would get it. You still get it every couple.
I do. So to everyone who's scared of your parents, what they're going to say about your tattoo. Just get it, wear a trouser. So for example, my big ones, with those ones like on my legs and stuff, or even my foot, I would always hide it from my mum. And then when she sees it like a year later, I'd be like, it's been there for a year. So that's what how I would get away with it. But I know mum wasn't happy. And like she would always give me the hmms as well, like hmm, hmm, every time she sees it. But then when we went to Ghana, she was like, get a dress, do you remember? Wait, yeah, so everyone can see your tattoos.
Oh my days.
Put the slit higher, your tattoos. Like, whatever, mum.
Do you know, yeah, that's so funny because that reminds that my mum would do literally the same thing. I like him.
Yeah,
like,
literally.
It would be like disgust. And then it would be, yeah, no, show it. You have these things, so show it off. Kind of thing. It's like, oh my.
So does your mum like you guys' new haircuts then, or is she still heartbroken?
Yeah. Like she'll come through. Like if you ain't got a trim recently, she'll be like, cut your hair, like, or comb your hair, or do whatever. And obviously, like, my mum's got locks and stuff,
yeah,
like, and I could be like, no, I'm trying to grow my locks now. But yeah. But yeah, so she's very much like that. And then in a similar way, like when I'm doing, like, obviously people who listen to the podcast know that I do like music and stuff as well,
yeah,
in a similar way, it's very much like, what are you doing with life? But also when things are like happening or whatever, it's all like, yeah, no, like, well done. Like, da, da, da. So it is that same kind of like A and B of A, like, I don't like this thing, but B, also I'm supportive of this thing, yeah, at the same time when I want to be. It's weird.
I guess they grow and get used to it. That's, they like your new you, if that, do you know what I mean? Mm. Yeah.
That's true. Especially like if you're growing into someone that like you're happy with.
Yeah.
Then that kind of radiates back to them, and I think, ooh, they have to accept
that's
it.
That's a very good. See, you see, the last 2 weeks I've been growing into someone that I'm happy with.
We love that.
That's been
we
my
love
last
that.
2 weeks.
So tattoo designs. Like, yeah. Tell us some of your favorite ones you've done.
Oh, so I don't know where to start.
Remember you tattooed me.
Yeah, so oh, actually, hold on. So let's start
so
there.
Ben's
what did you
got
get
a
him?
Very nice design of mine. He's got so he did a ship first, his one piece ship. But the thing is, when people do come to me.
Don't disrespect the guy Mary, man. It means something to me. R.I.P.
You know, but we didn't do the cartoony version.
Only 1,000.
Jokes.
No, you're not funny. But yeah, we didn't do a cartoony version. We did a realistic version. So a lot of the times when people do come to me with ideas, I will give them my advice as an artist. When I first started out, this wasn't something that I did. People just say, I want, like, for example, the one piece Go Merry exactly as it is. And I would just be like, you know what? Who am I to tell you anything? Mm. Let me just do it. But with years of experience, you kind of learn that not everything works. People can't just tell you what they want. You have to kind of guide them as an artist.
Yeah,
feel like hairdressers probably, I don't know, none of you lot are hairdressers, but I feel like...
No, you know,
yeah.
They cut locks.
I was going to say, on the weekend,
yeah,
you know?
So, yeah, you have to like kind of advise people. So, yeah, with Sabez, I did a realistic ship, but still the Go Merry, and we did Poseidon, the god of the sea, because Sabez is a Aquarius. Am I allowed to say this?
Are you?
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know.
Yeah, man, Aquarius life.
So yeah, Sabez has got, I do like doing bigger tattoos. My favourite designs, what would be my number one design? I like doing girls' faces. That's something that's fun to tattoo. I feel like quite a lot of artists like that.
Faces on other parts of the body.
And then sometimes you put tattoos on those faces on the other parts of the body.
That's jokes.
I know, right? Inception. Tatception.
So there's people like out here walking around with two faces.
Literally, I got for like four.
Lord.
I know, but I'm the realest
person. You can't trust that person.
No, I'm so
four
real.
Four faces,
I'm
know?
Very real. But yeah, I don't know. I think women's faces are odd. I wouldn't want a man's face, like just a big... man face.
Damn, why not?
Men are not the most prettiest. Yeah, I'm looking at you. It's the best. But no, I feel like, yeah, I do. I feel like women's faces are art. Men's faces are art because people get Zeus's and stuff. But like, I like women's faces. That's my thing. Yeah.
Okay.
Whatever. Don't hate. Get some women's faces. That's what you should do. Don't hate.
Fair enough. Cam, Bez, talk to me about tattoos then. Like, I know, Cam, you want to get more. You've still got the one, right?
Yeah, I'm still earning
it. What's your tattoo? Sorry.
It's just, it says
he's branded.
Six of six. I'm branded, yeah. Because my oldest brother and my sister, one of my sisters, got tattoos saying 1 of 6 and 3 of 6, and I'm the youngest, so I got 6 of 6. And then we tried to talk Yelz into getting one too, but he's like, "Oh, tattoos, no."
I think you should.
I think this would be like, in terms of wanting it, this is not like, it's not something that you can grow out of. You're always going to be the 5th of 6. Okay, you know?
But I actively hate that idea.
Oh,
okay.
Like, I don't actively hate, but that idea, I actively hate.
I think it's a beautiful idea.
No.
Oh.
I said if I'm going to do that, I would get 1 of 1.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. You guys.
Honestly, if I wasn't 6 of 6, I probably wouldn't get it because
no.
I am. Because I'm the last one and it's 6 of 6, I think it works.
That does work.
But I think 5 of 6 is kind of
lame.
A bit of a weird number. Yeah.
Exactly. So yeah, no way.
And then yeah, I do have some ideas for other ones. And then my sister's, she's recently started doing, she went to like a course to do tattoos as well. And so she has like a tattoo pen at her house now. And then, so she's going to do one for me, hopefully.
What's she going to do on you?
Well, she's only just starting out, so it's just something small. So I was thinking, like, what do I want? And then because this is super nerdy, but because I like maths and what are they called? Like plus times.
How
divide.
Can you say you like maths and you don't know what it's called?
I can't remember. I'm trying to remember.
Equations?
No, you talk about the calculations. The symbols,
yeah. So I'm like, those are pretty simple. And I wouldn't mind having them on my body somewhere. So I was like, you could do that for me. And then I have two other ideas for... I want an Uchat, which is like the eye of
Heru or Horus. Yeah,
on my chest, and then also the Ankh on my
right
arm.
See, this is the point of tattoos.
If you're gonna get the Uchat, the eye of Horus or whatever, you got to get it on your forehead, my guy.
Oh my god!
I can't have it on my forehead though, man. Come on,
you gotta get it on your forehead. That's where it's gotta be. You gotta be like the third eye is open. It's gotta be on your forehead.
Maybe on Halloween you could paint it on for the one day, but tattoo. Yeah,
not forever, man.
This is I think it's about decorating your body. How you feel.
If you're gonna do it, you gotta go the full 100 yards.
Oh my goodness. I wouldn't mind doing a forehead with a third eye if someone wanted me to. I'd honestly do it. But.
See, there you go.
But I don't want that, so I'm good.
But you were saying, and then what, the Ankh on the shoulder?
Yeah.
Okay. That's cool. I've seen like quite a few people with that. That's always a vibe. Bez, what about you, man? You got other designs?
I don't know. I wanted to get a dragon somewhere. Like Jean's going to kind of animate me up. So we're talking about getting a Dragon Ball. And
you lot were going to do like a similar thing to us, weren't you, with the Dragon Ball?
We were thinking about it, yeah, like doing something like with the Dragon Ball Stars sort of thing.
I'd get a matching tattoo, suppose.
You went to get like mum and dad or something, didn't you? Like you went to get quite a big, or like the picture of us or something you wanted to get.
I'm still going to get that, yeah.
Was that a matching one you wanted to get, or was that just you were going to get?
No, just for me, okay. Because I don't know if you'd be, I didn't think you'd be willing to get, there we go.
That's too big.
So they said he was going to tattoo me, do you remember?
Yeah, I was going to give you the straw hat.
I'm still ready, but I'm a bit scared because...
I'd be terrified.
It's all right. I trust the best to some degree, so I'm sure you won't butcher me.
I won't harm you. It may not look very good, but it won't hurt.
Oh, my goodness. But, Parkinson's did it.
Oh, my days.
Probably a little bit, yeah. But, I was because... I don't know if you remember the water dragon from Yu-Gi-Oh.
Mm-hmm.
Something, because I got the ship, the Poseidon, I wanted to get like, maybe a water dragon or something on the other side. So I was like, yeah, that was one of the thoughts. And that's pretty much where I was at the moment.
Okay.
But it's only me to get a 5 letters podcast one, man.
You should. He's not that. He doesn't want to do his siblings. He said 1 of 1 with his siblings, let alone the podcast, guys.
Yeah, then I'll get 2 of 2. Then he can get 3 of 3. And that could be the 5 letters
Makes sense.
Oh my god.
Ruin your idea.
To be fair, no one would know though. Like if they see the 1 of 1 of me, they're not gonna be like, oh yeah, there's gonna be a 2 of 2.
Yeah, true.
So would you get a sleeve?
I don't think I get a sleeve, just half. I keep a half sleeve.
Okay, am I allowed to add girls love guys with tattoos? This is a real thing to say to your listeners and podcast people out there.
Okay, but do you know what? Yeah. I want a woman.
You want a woman? Oh, sorry.
Growing, I want a woman.
Okay.
We ain't dealing with no girls around here.
Okay, cool. But yeah, and I do have a lot of clients who do come back and they say, literally, like, a lot of girls do give them more attention. I don't know why it's a thing, but it's an actual thing. Like, they get a lot more attention with tattoos than without tattoos.
Do you think it, like, obviously, like, how kind of fit trends go in? So you have, like, with, like, for example, women's bodies, like, slim was the kind of in fashion, then it became like slim thick is in fashion, and like kind
slim's
of gym bodies. Yeah,
slim's
now coming back. So do you think it might be like a thing where girls now like tattoos, but then it might be like 10 years time they're going to be like, no, we like clean
skin.
Yeah.
I had a friend saying this to me. This is why he would never get a tattoo similar to you, Ellie. He never wants to get a tattoo because he's like, you lot are just going through a trend. One day clean skin is going to make a comeback. But I don't know. I think girls, I don't know if it's to do with they think the man has money or if they think that he's a bad boy or they just like the look of the tattoos. But yeah, I don't know.
I think it's probably the bad boy thing.
I feel like there's
something associated
yeah.
with the tattoos and bad boys
yeah.
sort of thing.
Because culturally, like where tattoos come from, like tattoos initially, most of the time back in the day, you were either in the army or you were in prison.
Or Yakuza. He's speaking facts.
So, and then that's just where it's just come down from that kind of thing. Obviously, there's more to it, but that's in pop culture, that's kind of where that comes from. And then obviously we're in modern day, but that still kind of lingers about.
It's trickled, yeah, down to us.
Yeah, man. But for me, I'm just like, yeah, like, I don't know, man. I'll just be me fresh, fresh like the Lord made me.
Oh my goodness. But you cut your locks. No, I'm joking. See, would you get your ears pierced or anything?
Nah, I don't have my ears pierced. Like,
oh.
And I don't, yeah, I mean, it's too late now. Like, I think if...
Never too late. Nah. We tattoo 80-year-olds. Honestly, I've tattooed priests. Women
wow.
with hijabs come and take off their hijabs and they're covered in tattoos. You'd be surprised, yeah.
I love that for them. I love that for them.
Literally.
That's surprising, but yeah, wow.
Yeah, I've seen priests with sleeves. It's ridiculous. And they get Jesus all over them. Not Jesus all over them, but like Jesus, angel, praying hands, stuff. Like, religious.
That's
yeah.
mad. That's mad. Like, yeah.
You
but I ain't
know.
Trying to be a priest. No one ever said that Yells was a godly man.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, man. But nah, amazing. Any last thoughts about tattoos? What we're going to do, we're going to play a song and then we're going to come back and we can kind of just get into talking about any.
Yeah.
Anything. We'll kind of go where we're going. But before we do that, any last thoughts on tattoos? Any last... comments?
I'm trying to think, is there anything I should advise people?
How long have you been doing them for? I don't think you mentioned. You said years, but you didn't say how long.
So I've been tattooing for about, I started when I was 18, but that wasn't professional. That was like, do you want to hear, can I say the real story? How
course,
real
go for
am
it.
I
go
allowed
for
to
it.
Be?
Be as real as you want.
Okay, cool. So when I did first start out, I did start out as like I said, doing my friends, doing my neighbours. It wasn't really like a professional thing.
Mm-hmm.
It was kind of like I was going to people's houses and doing it with like my baby and everything. Yes, it was very scatty. But so yeah, at first I was really doing a real hard job to like, sorry, I sound really illiterate. It was really difficult to start out. And I feel like if someone did want to become a tattoo artist or whatever, it's a bit of a leap. If you want to do any job that is your passion, it is a leap in it. It's not like a thing where you know you're going to be okay. It's a bit scary.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
yeah, for the first few years, it was like very, very, it took me really long. It was hard to break people's skin. It was hard to work with skin. It was difficult to know how to talk to clients. Remember I said to you, for example, where you have to advise people, I wouldn't do that. So a lot of things would be coming out wrong. I didn't know how to use my equipment. But now I would say I've been professional for about 6 years. So
okay, okay.
I know exactly what I'm doing. No more mistakes.
Nah, we love the journey. We love, like, obviously everything is
you
always
know?
Like, you start from the bottom and now we're here.
It's true.
Start from the bottom, now we're here. All right, one last question. I don't know. You might have an answer to this. You might not. But... is there any like celebrity that would be like a dream like tattoo like person you don't
want to tell me? Why are you laughing?
And it's going to be Chris Brown, isn't
that
it?
That was exactly yeah. who I was going to say. It would be Chris Brown or Wiz Khalifa. Them two would be my dream people to tattoo just because I know they love tattoos. Not in a way that I want to give my work on Chris Brown, but I would love to do something so good. This is another thing, not just Chris Brown. Anyone that comes through, in my brain, I'm like, imagine this is Sebez you're tattooing right now. I do this sometimes. So damn. I have to really look after the person, you know what I mean? Mm. Or imagine this is your mum, or imagine this is your whatever. So sometimes I'll be like, imagine this is Chris Brown. You know, you give someone something that forever they're going to look at it and love it and be like, Janinne did this amazing tattoo for me. Mm-hmm. So that's why I would love to tattoo a celebrity as well. Because obviously the same feeling I get of a normal person, it would be amazing for every time I look at Chris Brown to be like, I did that trainer on his face and he loved it. Like, do you know what I mean? Yeah, so I would love to tattoo Chris Brown. So Bez knew it already.
Yeah.
Amazing, amazing, amazing. Right then. So let's get into a quick break. We're going to run a song. I think we'll get into... completely drawing a blank as to what songs we had. What songs do we have?
DB and Ed Sheeran, Lonely Lovely, I think it's called.
Yeah, let's get into that one. Why not? Why not? Yep, so don't forget to follow Janinne on her Instagram. That's at Janinne the Creator. That's JANINNE the Creator. And yeah, we'll catch you on the flip side.
Sometimes you can lose someone and you won't ever feel the same no more. Wanna give up, it don't feel right. But you don't wanna feel this pain no more. Bad things come to those that don't deserve it. Why do I only pray when I'm hurting? I might pour another glass, wish I had one more chance to just have one more dance.
And yes, that one right there, that was Lonely Lovers by D Block Europe, DBE and Ed Sheeran. So shout out to them lot. Yeah, so we're back. Janinne,
Can I just quickly mention Ed Sheeran was at an event I was at the other day.
Doing what?
So it was for SBTV, you know, Jamal Edwards.
Yeah, RIP.
It was his birthday, so they had an event and there was loads of celebrities there. There was Big Nasty, there was Ed Sheeran, there was Dave, there was Hailey from Western, there was JME. Yeah. It was like crazy. But yeah, Ed Sheeran was there. I missed him. But
you say Big Michael was there as well.
Big who?
Big Michael Stormzy.
Stormzy was there. Stormzy was there. I forgot to mention
Mel
him.
Mel made him do it. Yeah.
I met Stormzy. But yeah, it was cool. It was really cool. I missed Ed. My friend really wanted to meet Ed. But yeah, we missed Ed. But yeah, shouts out to Ed.
Man like Ed. And yeah, once again, RIP, obviously, Jamal Edwards, yeah. SBTV. Icon in this thing. But yeah, let's, for this episode, obviously it's our 2-year anniversary and we've got our very, very lovely special guest Janinne here with us. We thought for the second half we kind of just freestyle, kind of just hang out, see how it goes.
Wicked.
Janinne, did you have anything that you wanted to
talk? So during this little break when I went out to, you know, refresh my mind, my chakras. I did have a little thought. So basically I thought this is something I do want to bring up around guys. So I had a client the other day and she's got a new boyfriend. They've been together apparently 6 months. Mm-hmm. But a little bit of a backstory, this client's kind of like a girl who's always in different relationships.
Okay.
If that makes sense to you guys. With me? Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, cool. So she said to me, what do you think about second chances? And well, Sebez, you kind of know what my dating history is like. What do you think?
Yeah, I think you're pretty much okay with second chances. Like, multiple chances.
Yeah, I do like
third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh,
eighth. Too many chances until I just learn my lesson and I'm like, no. So Bez tells me every time I'm an idiot.
The 1200th chance is coming soon.
No, it's not. I rebuke it. But so yeah, my client asked me, do I think about second chances, to where her man started saying about they somehow got onto the topic of cheating. So he said that he thinks that for a man to cheat is nothing, but for a woman to cheat is something. So
I'm dying inside.
I thought it would be quite interesting.
Facts. I'm joking.
Bez is about to get flamed on this podcast. Oh my, you're going to see mum come out. literally. So I got into a bit of an argument with, see, this is a little backstory to my work. I do have a lot of fun conversations with my client, really interesting. Sometimes life-changing ones, sometimes I change their life, sometimes they change my life. But yeah, I got into a little bit of an argument with her boyfriend, basically, because his argument was, oh, when a man sees a woman, he just sees her and he just is attracted. And I was like, yeah, but women feel like that. And he's like, yeah, but I'm a lock. I mean, you're a lock and I'm a key. And ironically, I was doing a lock and key on this couple.
Oh my God.
That's so bad.
I know, right? I know. So then I kind of put it down to, you know what? He's a bit older as well. He's in his 40s. So I thought, he's a bit older, you know, his mentality might be a bit different.
That's 40 years old. You can't be thinking like that when you're 40
years old. Right?
That's terrible.
And they just got together.
It should be the opposite. If he was younger, it would make sense to have that mentality.
You know, and so again, he had this very kind of mentality that as a woman, if you're too loose, you'll use goods or whatever. Like, I don't judge people for what they do. Obviously, I have my own way of holding myself. But if you're a girl and you want to sleep with everyone you see, I don't judge you. And it's up to you what you want to do with your own body. That's the end of that, yeah. But there are some men who believe they can do that, but then as a woman, it's not right for you to do that. And he said, oh yeah, I had a hoe phase from when I was 19 to 30. And I said, yeah, but you're saying a girl can't even sleep with more than like 3 people. He's like, yeah, but that's different. It's not different. So I thought maybe it's just him, but then I spoke to one of my friends a bit later on and I had the same argument all over again with him. So what do you guys think? It'd be interesting to speak to see what other guys think. Be honest.
You probably come to the wrong podcast.
I'll say get better friends.
No. No, that's what I was going to say. No, I was going to say, you probably come to the wrong podcast because we're going to agree with you.
Okay. It's nice to hear that.
I can say that with confidence. I can just look at them and say that the three of us, we're going to agree with you just because of how we're wired. And
so you think that it's, you can understand where when a girl says it's both people have the same kind of urges, but it's down to self-control. Because some men will argue. And it's not even just, I guess, my two friends I've argued with. I feel like there's a lot of guys that do have this mentality that, like, men are meant to be monogamous and women are meant to be... Is it monogamous? Polygamous. Yes, polygamous. And women are meant to be just part of a troop with this one man. You lot must have seen it.
Yeah, no. That it's a common idea. And there's so many different theories. Like, I remember I heard one guy basically saying that men are meant to be polygamous because, for example, a woman, you get pregnant once and you're pregnant. And that's
this
it.
This is another argument,
but then
argument,
the man can still go around and spread his seed around, get some more women pregnant, blah, blah, blah. And this is how it's meant to be, blah, blah, blah. I was just like, oh my goodness.
You don't agree then. But then I feel like if there's men that don't agree, how can so many men argue that this is how men are? When I'm sitting with 3 guys right now who don't believe that,
because they're trying to speak for all men off of their own thoughts, when it's like they don't know. They obviously, their friends will think the same as them, so they're just gonna say all men when it's not that.
So me sitting with you 3 guys, can you give help to some girls in our generation and let us know that not all men think that we can cheat and you lot have got to like just listen to us and see what, like, there is hope, right?
Yeah. It's definitely a case of, like, I think it's definitely a case of like birds of a feather flocking together in that kind of thing, where it's like, if you think a certain way and all your man don't think a certain way, and you act a certain way in that, and then like all the people that you kind of come across, like, is also kind of like in that realm. Because also it depends on what you were raised around as well.
Yeah.
Like, so if your dad was like out doing a madness, or your uncles were out doing a madness, older brothers, whatever, out doing a madness, that kind of just, that socializes
rubs off on
you.
The kid.
Yeah, exactly. And then if you then grow up and like you're doing that, your boys are doing that, whatever, it then just becomes like, ah, oh, this is how men are. But yeah, it's definitely not a case. I think there's just more to it than that. Than to just be like, oh yeah, like men, like we're the lock. No, we're the key.
Yeah.
And you're the lock or whatever.
No. Both people should have self-control, basically.
Yeah, self-control and respect.
Yeah, that's what I agree with, yeah. So, Bez, you're very quiet over there. What do you think about this? Because this...
No, I agree as well. You know what I think. Yeah. I probably think about it. Like, I don't think that men should be... I mean, men should treat... It's the whole treat yourself how you want to be treated sort of thing.
True.
So if you want to go out there and spread your seed and sleep with 1,000 women, juice your apple as the guy. Yeah. we were coming back from somewhere and then we were speaking to the cab driver and he was telling us this, like, oh, as a man, you've got to juice your apples.
See?
You've got to juice your apples and all this. I got to go out there and juice his apples.
And if I'm like, can I juice my apple?
No. No.
That's exactly hilarious.
Like, if you want to, if as a man you want to go and juice your apples, you've got to expect that the women you're going to be seeing, so like, the apples have to be juiced for someone.
It's true.
So the women should be juicing the apples as well then, if that's how you're running.
Yeah, it's funny because the thing that I don't understand, the part that I don't understand anyway, is like, this is not how I carry myself, but if I was going to carry myself as like someone who was just going around just like clarting anything,
juicing
moves,
your apples,
juicing my apples, as it goes that way. Like,
best saying ever.
It's wild. It's wild. But I'm like, nah, for me, like, if that was going to be me, like, in my head, I'd be like, yo, I'd want a girl that would do the same.
Yeah.
Or at least I would understand if she wanted to do the same.
Yeah. So this was...
I'll say, like, I feel like you'd feel bad. Like, if I'm out here running through everything I see, and then she's at home, like, calling me while I'm there just clotting this thing, and I'm like... I feel so bad when I see her name pop up and like
okay,
and
so
with
I
her.
Love
and then
that you guys are bringing this up because the argument that I got into both times with both of these people that I had this talk with, like literally on Thursday, this was right. So how long ago is that? 2 days ago.
Yeah,
2 days ago. I said that if I had again, like you see how you say you feel guilty with this person that's loving you and sitting at home.
Yeah.
Yeah. So cool. I was saying if I had this lovely sweet boyfriend, I wouldn't be a cheater because I think that's so evil. But then. If I had a boyfriend who's cheated on me, and this is where they were trying to argue that I'm being emotional, but I said it's not emotional, it's logical, because if someone's done this to me, why am I being faithful? If I see a man at the gym and I fancy him and you've already cheated on me, I'm sorry, but I'm going to fuck the man at the gym now. Sorry, Sebez. I know, sorry, Sebez. But, you know, because it's like, so the example I gave to my friend, not the client's boyfriend, my friend, was if we both made an agreement, or for example, me and Sebez, we make agreements, we're not going to eat junk food, right? Or the example I gave to him is we're both going to stop smoking, right? And then I see him at the party smoking a cigarette, or someone's called me like, oh my God, do you know he was like smoking a spliff? I'm going to be like, what the hell? I'm going to smoke a spliff right now. Like, do you know what I mean? Like, do you get it? Do you know what I mean, Sebez? How would you feel if we agreed... we're not going to eat junk food. And then a major's like, no, mummy's been eating Mr. Kipling's all week.
Yeah, no, I'd be like, I'd be shocked.
Would you go and eat, would you go and
I would
cheat?
Definitely want to eat Mr. Kipling's.
See,
like,
exactly.
Like,
exactly.
It's even like obviously we'll speak about junk food and stuff and like, I'll tell you, you'll be like, you had your what would Sebez do thing where like I'm eating and I'll be like, oh, no, I've been eating shit this week.
And then some weeks I'll be eating so good for the whole week where I'll be looking at the Mr. Kipling like, just be strong. Sebez is doing so well. And then we check in and Sebez is like, no, I just ate, I had chips, I had 10 Mr. Kipling's.
And then Jean, we're going to have Mr. Kipling's as well. Because
because it's like, what the hell is
this
for?
What am I doing it for?
So that's my attitude towards the being faithful thing kind of thing. If you've got this sweet partner, the same with you guys. If you had a girlfriend, I guess with guys it's a bit different because you are so logical. See, I have this theory. I got to explain my little backing theory.
Mm-hmm.
Men are very logical and women are very emotional, right? So I feel like for men, if your woman was cheating, you would just leave. Well, if you have children, you have a child.
I don't need to be with a girl to be with the child.
If so, you'd leave.
If she cheated on me.
Yeah. Question time, guys.
Yeah, no, and I don't think it's logical. My reason is absolutely not, and I don't think it's. I think it's very emotional. I think my ego would not be having that.
Yeah.
Like just on that level, I'm like, nah, I can't. Me, how I'm built. Like, there's absolutely.
How
no
dare
way.
You?
Yeah, it's like I'm like, have you met me? And you're going to cheat on me? Are you mad? No.
It's funny because we were having this conversation at a barbershop the other day about the whole emotional, logical thing, and I think men are quite emotional as well.
Very emotional.
Very emotional.
You're right.
And I think women are not as emotional as men in a lot of cases.
I think men women have much better control of their emotions than men do.
Because we're allowed to some degree as well. We're kind of like, if I wanted to go burn down my man's house or cut up all his clothes, my friends would understand.
Nah, that's true.
I would understand if my friend told me that as well.
That's true, to be fair. If I said to like one of my mates, or if I said to Bez, like, yo, like, come with me, I'm gonna cut this girl's clothes. You look at me, you're like, are you mad? So
it's like that video. You remember the one where it's like, oh, if I die, he's dying too. And the guy's like, what?
See, I understand that, but I do agree with you. I think that men are a bit more emotional than people make out, innit?
Definitely. Cam, you look like you wanted
to say something.
Nah, I don't know. I don't know what I was going to say. I can't remember.
Talking about, would you cheat if your girl cheated back? Or if your girl cheated on you, would you cheat back or would you leave?
I would just leave. I ain't got time for that. That's too long.
Unless it's a joke.
Huh?
I said, unless it's a joke.
Shut up, man.
What do you mean? What does this mean? Unless it's a joke.
He's like, all right, as long as it's for the banner.
That's never for the banner. That's real, man. What's wrong with you?
Can you guys explain this to me, please?
I was literally when I was at home, I was like, I was hoping this didn't come up. I didn't want to have to explain myself again.
Well, for me and the listeners, as we're not aware of this inside
joke. The listeners, if they've been listening since last year, they should be aware too.
This is like a running joke in this podcast. Bez is over there dying.
You cheat for bands? Right.
No.
So, do you want to explain it?
No, you go ahead.
Are you sure? I'm gonna butcher you. I would let you explain it.
I'll explain it. So basically, it was like last year we were doing a segment where we were looking at posts on Reddit, I think it was.
Mm-hmm.
And some guy was talking about how his friend and his girlfriend, they were playing Dungeons and Dragons.
Yeah.
So they were role-playing this scene. His friend and his girlfriend were role-playing this scene of them. I don't know if they were having sex or they were being flirty or whatever.
So the role-play, because I remember, they were booking a hotel room to go beat.
And pretending it's role play.
Yeah, so they're just talking about it, but it's obviously within the game, the Dungeons and Dragons game, so it's not like a serious thing. And then they posed the question. We all answered whether we would be okay with that, and I said I'd be okay with it in a situation where it's just jokes. if we're all having a good time, we're all laughing.
But where does the joke end?
The joke ends when the game ends. If the joke doesn't end when the game ends, then it's a problem. But if it's within the game and we're all laughing, we're all having a good time, then I'm like,
They're in the hotel room alone together.
This is what I'm saying.
They're not really in a hotel room. So you know how Dungeons & Dragons works, where they're on the board game and then they roll the dice and be like, oh, you book a hotel room.
Oh, yeah.
So it's like us before sitting in the room right now and playing a game like that. So they're not actually going to a hotel.
I thought they were really going to the hotel room.
So they're not really going to the hotel room, but they're like...
on the game, they had to go to the hotel.
So in the game, but because of the way the game is and you're just talking through stuff or whatever. So it'll be like, oh, I walk up to the hotel desk and I look at like so-and-so. I give him a wink.
Oh,
be
my
like,
gosh.
Oh, yeah, we're going to have a lot of fun tonight.
See, like, from the female point of view, the game would not go past the wink at the... as soon as your boyfriend lands on it, bitch, you better roll again and skip. That's my boyfriend.
But that's my
This is what we were all saying. We were like, absolutely not, game or no game. Yeah. Like, be respectful of what's going on right now.
In my head... I can see it being a funny situation because it is just them talking about it.
Mm.
It's not like
that shows a lot of security. To be fair,
absolutely.
Couldn't be me.
Yeah, absolutely.
Trying to break it down to make it sense. Like, the whole board game over, friendship over.
Because it's not. I'm just saying it's not serious. There's no. If it becomes a thing where it starts popping up outside of the game, and then it starts to seem serious.
Okay.
Then I'm like, nah, this needs to shut down right now.
All
right.
So if your friend and your girl beat just to beat, it's not serious.
It is serious. That can't be the not serious. There is no not serious in that situation.
They had an itch that they needed.
The thing that makes it okay is that I'm there to be in on the joke as well. if I'm not there, then there's a bigger issue also.
So you want to watch?
You lot are just turning this into something else.
You want to be in the room where it happens.
This is what it's sounding like to me, who's brand new to this as well. Fresh pair of eyes.
Look, I don't know.
You sound very secure, basically. Like, yeah, you could take a joke.
I think it could be funny. I think if it's not funny, then I'm not about it. If it's funny, I'm happy to be
okay,
there and
so
have a laugh with
if,
it.
If they're role-playing, right, and you're doing the... Just to take it back and be serious again for a second.
Mm-hmm.
If they're actually playing the Dungeons & Dragons and they're role-playing and whatnot, and they're doing this whole thing, but it's not funny. They're not finding it funny. You're not finding it funny. No one around the table is laughing.
If they're not doing it for laughs, then I'm not about it.
Okay.
So if they're doing it to try and make me laugh, like they're like, haha, look at this, look what we're doing, then I'm like, cool.
What kind of game is this?
I would watch out for them kind of friend.
I what? Know, right?
I'd watch out for that friend.
I would watch out for that
and
friend
that girl
too.
As well. I'm like, no. Yeah.
I don't know, man. I don't know. I think, obviously, it depends on the situation. If it's something that I could see where it's like, it could be a problem because of I know my friend and I know my girlfriend, it could be a problem. Then I'm like, nah. But if it's like, This is like just the relationship that we have. It is a fairly secure relationship.
Yeah.
And I know my friend's not going to try and beat my girl. Like, that's not going to happen. Then I'll be
okay
with it.
You never know in this life. Like you kind of know to some degree, but you never know. And they'll some people think we could get away with it, if you know what I mean. They're like, oh, we're doing the game and he's not minding. Maybe we can, you know what I mean? Like, baby stepping you into it. But I love your security. I wish I was that secure.
Mm. I probably would do the role play.
Sorry, everyone was very concerned. Like, you should have seen. Like, I wish this is one of the moments where I wish we had cameras in here, because Janine's face, Bez's face, my face, we were all like, hold on a minute, what is this guy about to say?
You said about the cuck thing. I probably would role play that in the game, because okay, that would be funny.
Okay. Moving on.
Well, it would be funny. I would never do, not in real life ever. Not in real life ever. But in the game, it would be funny.
So like, the game, okay, so the game's playing, they've gone to the hotel, wink, wink. They've walked into the hotel room there.
Oh my God.
Getting close, roll, knock, knock, Cam's at the door. Cam walks in. Cam takes a seat.
Roll don't
dice.
Mind me.
Yeah, don't mind.
Don't
oh,
how much continue. More this role, guys. How much more?
Please,
honestly,
please,
that sounds hilarious.
On.
That sounds hilarious to me. I'm not lying. Like,
Cam,
on the real, that sounds
behind
funny
the
to
curtains.
Me.
Cam unzips trousers.
Oh lord.
Oh lord, no more rolls, please.
Nah. I'm like, game done. I'm
but
sorry.
Yeah, my point was, I wouldn't cheat on a sweet innocent boyfriend. I would just cheat on the cheating boyfriend until I get bored and leave.
Yeah, I was about to say, like, I wouldn't cheat on either one.
The sweet
innocent one. Like, it will be what it will be, and the cheater will get left.
So what do you guys think about the dating pool? Again, see, I'm asking you the questions that as a girl I think about in terms of dating. Obviously, I'm willing to talk about a lot of things, but at the moment, I guess dating's kind of what a lot of people talk about. Do you know what I mean? But
unfortunately.
Like, you know, unfortunately, for real.
We were a relationship podcast once upon a time.
For what second? So like, round about that time when we were talking about
yeah,
that
so about
thing.
About a year ago,
yeah, we used to talk about
so yeah, so Bez told me
we became a politics podcast.
Really?
Because we were just kind of going with what was going on in the world, and just as the world, like, just a lot was happening, like, in politics and stuff.
Yeah.
And yeah, we just kind of transitioned. And now,
well, I'm happy to talk about it. I don't want to make it too romance-based, because obviously, but it's winter, everyone's getting booed up, as they say, except me.
God forbid.
Yeah. And Ayeli, clearly, he's God forbidden too. But I hear the dating pool's trash from Sebez. That's what Sebez says to me.
What?
I was out the game. I stopped.
Yeah, he's out the game, because he's out the game.
No, well, like, before I was out of the game. Like, earlier in the year, I was like, I'm done. Like, I deleted all apps. So I was like, I'm done. The scene is so trash. I don't want to be here anymore.
Guy, what makes... No, go on, sorry.
No, I'm saying, I agree. I don't want to be here.
All right, cool. So what makes it trash for a guy then?
Like, it's boring. I ain't gonna lie to you. It's like legitimately boring, like, in terms of just... Even the things that are meant to be exciting and whatnot, like going out on dates or whatever, whatever, like after you've been doing it, it gets like, oh, this is long.
So what do you mean? Do you think it gets long after like dating three different girls and going on the first date? Or you mean it gets long after dating like one girl and going on three dates and then you realise that it like this girl?
I think even getting to the point of going on a date is boring. It's like, it's just...
No!
So, all right. So he's right about that. But I'm saying like, so either option is can be kind of boring. But he's definitely right about the whole getting to that point is kind of boring as well, because like, you're going through like the same conversations, and obviously like the thing is, you're coming from the point of, I've had this conversation a million times. I also know you've had this conversation a million times.
Yeah.
And neither one of us really want to be having this conversation
again.
You got to
switch up and be like, I like purple elephants.
But then the thing is, what the hell, yeah. What the hell are you talking about? And it screenshots you. And now you're in a group chat.
Oh, no.
Trending on Twitter. Like, what the hell is this guy talking about?
Oh, no. You're right, to be fair. Because if a guy did send me that, I would just be like, ?, or block. So
I'll say, if you didn't reply, that's more than a lot of people would probably do.
Yeah.
Because, like, for me, I definitely, like, I take long breaks. So then when I come back, like, to, like, say, dating apps or whatever,
yeah,
I'm very, like, bright-eyed, bushy-tailed, like, let's get it.
Yeah, oh.
Like, I'm like, let's get it. Like, not in the kind of,
you're
like...
Renewed,
but not in the kind of, like, oh, like a romantic kind of sense, but in a kind of...
Oh, God.
I got time today.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so, but, yeah, in a way of, like, okay, cool, I'm going to come at this. Like, I'm going to be, like, trying to be as interesting as possible.
Are you looking for, like... a partner, or is it you just come in like, what's so yeah,
I'm coming at it from an angle of like, I'm just trying to see like what's out there, because like, at this point I'm jaded, I guess.
Okay.
So like, whenever like I go in the apps and stuff, I'm just like, let's just see what's popping. Like, ultimately, obviously, I'd like a partner somewhere down the line, but like, I can't go on it like, yo, I want a partner, because like, in the back of my head, I'm like, absolutely not. This is not going to happen. Like, yeah. Blah, blah, blah. So I'm just like, let's just go see what's out there, what's popping on the streets, whatever. So then I go in there like, yeah, okay, cool. I'm about to like be the most interesting person like of all time.
Yeah.
Okay. And then like...
But why do you want these girls to think you're interesting?
I don't necessarily want them to be think I'm interesting. I just want to have interesting conversations.
Oh, okay. Yeah, fair enough. Yeah.
So I'm like, all right, cool. So I'm a, like, if you got something interesting in your profile, I'm going to bring it up. And
yeah.
Like, and I'm going to try and take it in a direction that I will assume no one else is taking it.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's always possible, but like, that's what I'm going to try to do.
Yeah.
And then just after a while of doing that and whatever, and then just, it just... Like, it chips away at you, innit? Like, you just get chipped away, your enthusiasm just...
Completely. So I feel like the times when you, for example, you come in, I'm going to be the most interesting person, and you say something like they've got a profile with a nice background, and then you say, oh, wow, that place looks amazing. Where was it? And they just give you, like, a one-word answer. And you're like...
Yeah.
Then you've got to come in, oh, what was it like? Was it good? And then they're not really giving you anything. It's like, there you go, you're chipping.
And also, more to the point, all right, so, and that's... And on the one hand, I'll give them the bail. I'll be like, yo, okay, cool. It's your picture. It's your background. Maybe someone else has spoken about your background before. Blah, blah, blah. Maybe you've had that. Maybe you've had that conversation a million
this
times.
This is crazy. I've never been on a date in that. But yeah.
No?
Yeah,
oh, okay. Right. Cool.
Okay, this is crazy. Actually. Yeah.
So then what I would do is I will try and bring up something about myself that I think is kind of interesting.
Yeah. About.
And I'll be like, I'm going to just put this out here.
Yeah.
Like, do something with it.
Like DJ. For example,
that's almost always something that's on my profile.
Yeah.
And like, it's one of the most things that people want to talk about, but it's usually like just the most dry version of the conversation. Like,
it's crazy like, to hear
that,
this.
That can be had. Like, it's like, oh, so you DJ. Yeah. Like I have a radio show. I play clubs. Like, da, 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 da. And like,
yeah,
you'd expect people to be like, oh, where have you played? Like,
yeah.
Or like, yeah, just various like things like that. But then you just get, oh, that sounds fun.
I have so many mental notes on everything that you guys have just said. It's like, okay, cool. Because I feel like my first point I'm going to get back to is I feel like people might not be able to think as deeply as they used to be able to because of social media. Our thoughts have kind of been, not slowed down, but you know when, for example, TikTok, every 10 seconds you're seeing something different. Remember I was saying this on Sunday, to the point that you can't even remember what the last thing you saw was anymore because so many different things has scrolled past your brain to where some girls might not even, their thought process won't be to, where have you DJed? It'll just be like, oh, wow, that's fun. Because that's how their thoughts are formed. If you know, people aren't really deep thinkers anymore. People aren't geniuses. So it's like, and then the other thing on, say, the dating app as well, which does link into it, is like, it's mad because it's like you're advertising yourself.
Yeah.
As a man or a woman on a dating app. That's why I was like, it's mad. I've never had a dating app. So I've never had to do this or be like, do I have to come across as interesting? Is this person interesting me? I've kind of just like, you know, you just meet people. Like, I meet people. I like organic meeting people, to be honest. I feel like, I don't know, a dating app to me seems very, very wild. But,
Hey, you've done very well to say that. I'd advise you just to
don't
continue.
Go on it. Just no, do the natural.
I think organic is better. It's way better.
Okay, cool. And like, yeah, I think... On a dating app, you probably would meet a lot of shallow, empty, not much to them people. And I feel like women, this is something I was going to say to you, what are you on the dating app for? Because I feel like women, deep in their hearts, are looking for a husband and to settle down. And a lot of women now be like, I don't want no man. Like, people are very, like, can I say damaged or hurt or whatever. Mm-hmm. So it's like, I guess everyone does have the little fairy tale, but people are, like, kind of showing off. So it's like... When a normal nice guy who, like, for example, you guys are like, I think cheating, a woman should never cheat, or I don't want tattoos or whatever. They want the tatted cheating, I'm going to beat you up, boys. Like.
Chris Brown.
No, don't be like that. But do you know what I mean? So it's like, that's probably the guys who they will be asking them, like, oh my God, I see you sell drugs. Where do you sell these drugs? Like, do you know what I mean? Like, so it's like, I feel like do be your authentic self still, but it's just maybe, I don't know, dating apps for me are very... Nah.
Like, and that's the thing. I can only be myself. That's like one of my slogans.
Stay yourself.
I'm never gonna change, and it will be what it will be. And not to get it twisted, I've met like obviously some lovely people off like dating apps, and had like amazing dates and had great times. That you
is
know,
it more straight
ended,
to the point?
Whatever.
Would you say than like if you met someone like in the library, for example? Yeah.
Um, Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Because obviously there's just no, there's less room for that kind of confusion, kind of thing. Like,
you can't friend zone me. We're both here for the same thing. That's what I'm saying.
Like, in terms of if you meet someone in the library, like, it should just be like, oh yeah, you're cool, I'm cool. And
we like books.
Yeah, we like books, and let's go out to eat with my boyfriend.
We'll play Dungeons and Dragons in front of my boyfriend. Sorry, do you have a dating app? Do you go on dating apps? Have you ever had dating apps?
Nah, not really. No, I've had, like, I think I've installed Tinder at one point.
Yeah.
When I was like 18, which was like 6 years ago now.
How was your experience of it?
I never really used it, so I didn't really use it. So I didn't really speak to anyone on it at all, because I don't really care. I don't really care for dating apps. I don't really like the concept. So I'm like, I'm against it. Yeah. So
would you be a bit, so if a girl's like messaged you and she's got like, I'm a DJ in her bio, would you be like, oh, that's cool?
I honestly can't imagine why I would do. Like, I can't imagine why I would do in a situation, because I'm like.
No, but say you're having a conversation with someone.
Mm.
And. Yeah, they bring up what they do for a living. It doesn't have to be, oh, I'm a DJ. It could literally be, you know, I'm a flipping accountant. I don't know.
Yeah.
But, there's follow-up questions to that.
Yeah, right? Yeah, definitely. Well, I mean, the thing is for me is that I'm not very good. I don't do conversations well.
Okay.
And I overthink stuff too much. So I would try to try and keep the conversation moving, and get ask questions and whatnot. But I'm sure at some point I would overthink it and accidentally shut the conversation down rather than keeping it moving.
See, maybe sometimes this is what these girls on Tinder are doing. Yells, should I call you on this podcast?
I mean, being given the government the entire time.
So. I'm so sorry. But yeah, maybe they're overthinking. They don't want to ask the wrong thing.
They're not overthinking. Oh. Like I very rarely will say make a super statement like that, but I assure you they are not overthinking.
Okay. I feel like they're not overthinking.
I think everyone's jaded.
I think for girls where I think I'd give them the benefit of the doubt is that it's more they just have so many options on there that they're just jaded. And so I feel like a lot of them wouldn't even reply because they just, like, I remember seeing one of our friends' Tinder accounts.
Yeah.
And, like, she had 99 plus likes on her account. And I was just like, flipping heck. Like, I have about 4. And 99 plus, like, the most you can get, obviously, because I didn't even know. And I didn't see how many matches she had. Literally, I didn't see how many matches she had along with that as well. And I'm just like, that's crazy. So, like, for her to go through all the people who are messaging her, actually, who matched her and stuff, like, you would be either missing messages or you would just be jaded.
But then I feel like girls should only be on Tinder for, like, a week then, and then just, you know what, I found the guy I'm looking for, and that's it, I'm bouncing.
They don't. That's the problem. That's the problem. And that's why they get jaded, because they've met 200 dickheads, or maybe not even dickheads, just 200 people they're not interested in. And then,
or it could be the guy they think they like, and then they delete it after a week, and then this guy turns out to be a douchebag, and
they have to come back.
They're back on it, yeah.
But now they're back with the idea that the last guy I met from here was a dick.
Yeah.
So.
Well, yeah, I understand. So, like, back to the little 2 week thing again. So, like, cool. Like I said to you guys, well, I don't want it to be too. Obviously, if you want to talk about relationships, that's cool, but not too relationship based. So it's like, on the other side of the things, rather than keep going back to Tinder, why don't you take time out for yourself?
Oh, so, we do.
No, not you guys. Oh, okay. But I mean, like,
I'm about to say, me and Bez been talking. Like, I've been off the apps for like a good 8 months or something at this point. Like, yeah.
Yeah, I hope so. Bez is.
I've been off them since the year started.
He should be now.
I am.
But I feel like a lot of girls don't get off Tinder. They will just go back and do another douchebag. But, like, yeah, at the moment I'm trying to not go back and do any more douchebags, and Sebez not speak any 130 of chances into existence for me as well. But I think healing is another part, major part of, like, love lives, I guess, isn't it?
I think everyone every now and again just needs to take a break and, like, focus on, like, doing them and being themselves or whatever. Absolutely.
So what do you guys think people should do in their spare time of the not being in a relationship?
Find a new hobby, man. Like, do something that you haven't done before. Like, yeah. And learn it. Because, like, there's a lot of things in this world that people just don't engage in. I feel like the average person just doesn't engage in...
NPCs.
I wasn't going to say that. But, like, I feel like the average person is very much like, all right, I go to work, I come home, I, like, watch TV, I cook.
Yeah.
Maybe I go to church or, like, if I'm a religious person, whatever, whatever. And that's kind of like the cycle of it. Like, my entertainment is maybe going out for a drink or whatever, whatever.
Yeah.
But I feel like, the average person, most people don't have a hobby.
No, you're correct. What's your hobby?
Gym, probably.
Yeah.
Running.
And PlayStations and stuff.
Yeah, but that fits into the category of NPC, like, I feel like.
I'm thinking like, all right, so PlayStation is definitely a hobby. Or gaming is definitely a hobby. Let me not, like, do that. But I mean,
otherwise, comfy, honestly.
Is that one of your hobbies?
He's a big gamer.
My biggest thing.
But you got your Switch.
Yeah, man. It's deep. It can be deeper than that. But yeah.
But I'm saying like, or at least if you're gonna be a gamer, like, or I'm just saying people should find like a niche.
Yeah.
I feel like people would be far more interested if everyone had like
something they really love.
Something they really, really love, their own niche that wasn't something that you would hear from like a million other people. And this is another thing that on dating apps, everyone's profile is the same.
Yeah, oh really?
Like, what's the typical Sunday? Brunch with the girls and then cinema, like, da, da, da. And it's like, yeah, like,
that's you crazy.
And
like,
Sunday, bruv.
You and 75 other million people.
Is it really like that? So there's no individuals really anymore.
It can feel like you're just talking to like clones.
Yeah, because I asked you guys about the dating, how is it trash for guys? And I guess this is part of the reasons it's trash.
Definitely. So that's my thing. I would say, like, if you wanted to take time away from dating, or if you just recently broke up, like, yeah, focus on yourself. But also find something that's uniquely yours, or as close to uniquely yours as can be. Like,
that sounds like great advice. I recently had a breakup. Is it recent, Sebez? Would you say recent?
It's been a few months now, isn't it?
Yeah, like June, end of June-ish.
Yeah, it's recent-ish.
Yeah, and normally I'll go back to my other person I give chances to.
Just back and forth.
Literally, but this time I've decided no more doing that. I'm not going to do dating apps. I'm just going to find myself. Like you said, get a hobby, read some books, and it's actually really refreshing because I feel like there is a lot of pressure to settle down with someone and be in a relationship and be, do you know what I mean, dating. So I guess that's why. I feel like as human beings, all of us have that thing in us at the end of the day that I would go as far as to say all of our life's mission is to reproduce. I would literally go as far. I feel like the desire to attract a mate drives us, on a subconscious level, ridiculously. Like, people might not admit it. Guys get flashy cars to attract women. Like, we're literally driven by... Do you know what I'm saying?
Women
dress ourselves to do all of that to attract a mate. So I think it's nice to, like, just take that time. This is the first time I've ever done it, taking the time to just get to know myself. And yeah, I think I should promote to everyone who's listening, get to know yourself.
Yeah, absolutely. Like, in order to love someone, you have to love yourself first. And in order to love yourself, you have to know yourself.
You're very correct.
Yeah, very wisdomous.
Wisdomous.
Yeah, I don't want it to all just be about promoting, like, cheating and get with someone and find someone and dating apps. Like, sometimes there is the other side of dating, which is do get to know yourself, do improve yourself, do have it. So, like, if you do go on a dating app, you're not just going to be, like you said, like one of the 75 million other girls who has no depth or personality or anything.
And guys, too, to be fair. I reckon it's probably the same on the flip side.
I reckon it is.
What do I feel like it's like dating guys? So, I don't really, like I said, I don't really go on dating apps and stuff. I'll get to know guys. So, for example, Carnival, I'm very much between the two same people. Like, me and Spence have been saying this whole podcast. But I did decide new start. So Carnival, I did give out my information, but it's like after a week of talking to about five guys, you lost podcast. I was like, you know what, it's boring. Like you said, it's just boring. Everyone's same dead chat. Like, no one. And another annoying thing is they'll say, let's go do something, or can I see you, or meet up, but there's no plans. I hate that. Girls hate that, by the way. If you want to meet up with a girl,
We've spoken about this before on this, haven't we?
Have you? Yeah. What was the topic? What did you lot say?
I feel like I was saying that.
Yeah, you were saying. Kind of you like, were, I said they give like a location in something, but like you can kind of. Like if I say meet me in Shoreditch, we can find something to do there.
That's ooh, fine, but I think one. Because I think one thing that we disagreed on, I was saying that like if you make plans to see someone, you have to check in with them. Like,
oh yeah, I remember.
Like the day before at least.
Okay, yeah, of course, yeah.
I'd be like, is this like, are we still doing this? And Bez was like, nah, we made the plan. It's in the diary.
But if you're dating someone, don't you talk every day?
Can do.
Yeah, but then you could be talking, but you might not necessarily say like, I'll be swimming up tomorrow.
That too, yeah. No, but me, I would be like oh, by the way, like, sorry, are we still doing this tomorrow?
No, I'm like, we've made the plans. Like, we don't need to speak about it again because it's agreed. I want
to hear from him the night before to make sure this is still happening, because otherwise I'm going to just sleep in my bed all day and be like, well, you didn't contact me the night before, so.
Yeah, this is
why dating pool is trash. Like, we made plans. It's in my diary. I'm getting a calendar notification about this from like 4 hours before, and you're in bed sleeping saying, oh, well, you didn't message me.
You wouldn't think it's still going ahead. I actually need you to let me know. Like, you have to be as excited as I am. Should I be excited? Should I not?
That's what I was saying as well. I was like, it's a good way to convey, or at least it gives you an opportunity to convey excitement.
You're looking forward then, to it.
Like,
yeah.
When she goes, yeah, let's do it. And you're like, great. I'm like, I'm excited to see you. Or I'm looking forward to it. Or I'm blah, blah, blah. So it gives you that opportunity to like kind of be like, yeah. So I'm like, yeah, always.
Yeah,
always.
I totally agree. Another thing that's kind of like holding me back at the moment is I don't like messaging, dating. I prefer phone calls and FaceTimes, and I hate messaging.
I hate that.
Ew.
Really?
Yeah. That's probably one thing that's definitely like I kind of go back and forth.
Yeah. Me too.
Actually, no. I can tell you clearly what it is.
Yeah.
If I've spoken to you enough via text to the point where I feel like we'll have an interesting conversation,
yeah,
then by all means, we can call.
Yeah.
Every now and again, not all the time, but okay. Yeah, sure. But like, other than that, text me. Do not call my phone.
Yeah.
Oh no.
I hate phone calls.
No way. I feel like your generation, so I feel like, are you my generation? I'm 30.
I mean, I'm 24, I don't know.
So is he my generation?
Yeah. It's kind of.
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, cool. All right, cool. And that was for millennials.
Millennials, yeah.
Yeah, we're millennials, yeah.
Yeah.
You're not a millennial.
I'm like on the cusp of millennial and the next
Gen
one.
Gen Z.
Yeah.
I'm
in
97.
Yeah, I'm literally, if you look, some places you'll see me.
I'm pretty sure, I feel like Gen Z starts in 96.
I feel like he might be a bit of a generation.
I mean, but there's not,
I know. And it doesn't matter, but I'm just saying, just if we want to be technical, I feel like Gen Z starts in 96.
I feel like you could see many the sources saying different things. Sometimes Gen Z, like, sometimes.
What's it called?
I don't like phone calls, but I think that's more just a me thing than a generational thing.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Because, and especially with phone calls, if it's a phone call, I don't feel like I can do anything else.
I agree,
if it's text messages, then I can first of all take time to think about what I'm going to say next.
Yeah.
And then second of all, I can do other things.
No, see, as a girl, I like the instant, the rapid responses, quick think on your feet.
I feel like after a certain amount of time, I can get into that, like quick responses. Yeah. But initially, I need to just make sure I'm saying the right things in the right places. You know?
I'm just like, nah, meet me in person. Like, either text me or meet me in person. Yeah. I'm just saying, text me or meet me in person. I don't really want to do this phone call thing because, more time, like, I'm doing something. So, it's just like, I can't be.
Yeah.
And it will be like, if I'm doing something and talking to you, like, it will be like, what are you doing? You know, I feel like you're not paying attention.
So, do you guys talk to your respective love interests every day? Do you call them every day, or is it like
call them every day?
So yeah,
it must be mad.
No one.
Like, not since I was 14.
Guys don't do phone calls every day. What about if she's been your girlfriend for a year?
Absolutely nah.
No.
Would message every day.
Yeah, I would talk to you every day.
I'd talk to you every day, but I wouldn't call you every day.
Phone call? No.
I wouldn't call you at all.
I'm in utter shock. Why?
Yeah, I'm not the one initiating phone calls. That's for sure.
Okay, this is really interesting.
Why?
I feel like if I don't speak to him every day, I'm not my partner. Sorry.
What? No. But we will speak every day.
Even I don't like messages.
By text or voice note.
Okay, if you message me and you know I don't like messages and I reply to you like 4 hours later, is that a problem?
Depends, like, 4 hours later, what we're talking. Like, for example, if I message you at 10 a.m.
Yeah.
And you reply at 2 p.m., that's fine. That's in the day. Okay. You're busy. Whatever.
Yeah.
If I message you at 10 p.m. and you reply at 2 a.m., oh. I'm going to be like, hold on a minute.
Is that a problem?
What? I'm just be like, what happened?
Is that really a problem with guys?
I think for me, yeah. I mean, it depends.
I'd have questions. Like, if you didn't say anything beforehand, yeah, to be yeah. like, yeah, I'm going out, or like, whatever.
Yeah.
Then I'll be like, hold on a minute, what happened?
Well, she said, I fell asleep and I woke up and messaged you. So I fell asleep. I knew what you lot was going to think. But some people do really fall asleep, you know. Man. Not everyone is doing the madness.
Oh, man. That's we know what that code means.
I prefer phone calls all the time. So at least, like, do you know, phone calls for me is way better, especially your boyfriend, your partner.
But then, like, so when you have a phone call, what, you speak for how long on the phone?
Even if it's like 5 minutes, like, how are you? So let's say you call me when you wake up, first thing you wake up, 10 o'clock, call me at 10 a.m. How are you, Janine? Good morning. You all right? I'm good. How are you? What are you doing today? All right, cool, cool, cool. Maybe phone me. I might phone you when I get to work. What are you doing? I'm at work.
So you start work at 2 or 1.
Yeah.
So that's 2 calls before lunchtime.
Yes.
And then you work.
No, it'll be when I wake up and then when I get to work. So that's 2 calls.
And about, okay.
Yeah, lunchtime.
And then you
when
work.
When I leave work.
Third call.
When I get home. But really and truly, you should
or
be
should
there.
Or should you be on the phone
house.
The whole time?
No, not the whole time.
No, I mean like from your drive home from work.
Maybe. Possibly. Maybe one of my friends could fill that space. But this is how girls honestly think.
You're like a chatty patty, though. That's what it is. Because, I feel like, all right, Bez, I feel like we could probably count on one hand the amount of times me and Bez have spoken on the phone in life.
Oh my
literally.
Like, and then we've been friends, what, 15 years?
More than that. It's funny because we always say 15 years, but it's now like almost 18
is
years.
It? Almost 20.
Yeah. Literally. And like, it's very, very rare that we will talk on the phone. Like,
and it's only if there's something urgent as well. It wouldn't be like, just, oh, how are you doing? You all right? Like,
oh, so girls shouldn't take it personally if a guy doesn't want to talk on the phone to her.
It depends on the guy.
I mean, it definitely depends on the guy. With me, it's never a personal thing.
Yeah.
Like if I don't want to talk on the phone, it's probably because I don't want to split my attention between two things.
Yeah.
If I'm doing absolutely nothing, can you say, and you call me, I'll answer and be like, yeah. I mean, to be fair, I'm not going to ignore your call. If you got a call, I'll answer. But if you like send me a text first, like, oh, do you want to kind of call you? I'll probably be like, eh.
No, you can't do that. You have to just call.
You call me and you'll know when I'm like, I can't just talk. Because I was like, I'm just not.
But you're my brother. See, you see how you lot feel the 10 a.m. thing, like 10 p.m., sorry, why did she ignore me? I'll feel that if I call my boyfriend, he doesn't answer, whether it's 10 a.m. or 10 p.m. I won't feel that with you, Sebez. It was you're my brother. I'll be like, I don't care what Sebez is doing. Well, all right. But if I call my boyfriend, he's like, I can't talk right now. Like, what do you mean you can't talk right now?
Yeah, nice. I'm watching Netflix, mate.
Oh my god, you better pause that shit.
Nah, do you know how frustrating? This is one reason why I also hate phone calls, especially when they're unannounced. Is that it's so intrusive.
Like, literally,
how rude of you to feel like you could disturb my day like this.
it's like, so if I message you then, like as your boyfriend, I message you saying like, oh, how are you?
Yeah,
you just call me rather than saying I'm fine.
Now say I'm all right, how are you?
So we can't, why can't we just talk on text?
But then, okay, so we can do that. And then let's say it gets to the next day and that happens again. I'm going to have a problem now. And did I only get this one message for the whole day?
No, you speak throughout the whole day, the
day
before.
I wouldn't probably speak throughout the
whole
day.
So you do get, because you haven't replied.
No!
So it's how
it in my eyes.
Even then, no.
The conversation ends with that good morning.
Oh, so you have fingers then.
I prefer phone calls. I feel like it's so much easier, because again, like, you see how you lot said with the messaging, I can't do anything while I'm messaging and I'll forget to get back, and I have people messaging my phone that I don't want to necessarily like reply to. So when my boyfriend's message gets lost in that bunch of messages, I'm like, you know what, you should have called me.
That's jokes, man. That's hilarious. For me, I just like messages that I'm not ready to reply to yet, I just ignore and they just go down.
Would your girlfriend be in that down list?
No. Like, I can text, if I'm seeing someone, I can text them all day if the conversation is interesting.
Okay.
Like, I'm not doing this, oh, what are you doing now? What are you doing now? Absolutely not.
That's what phone calls are like.
Oh my day. See what I'm saying? Like, nah. But if it's like, oh, good morning, like blah, blah, blah. Ah, look at this cool tweet I saw about XYZ, and then we're talking about whatever topic is like, throughout the day. Like, I can do that. Rago, I absolutely cannot be on the phone all day.
This is probably why I'm struggling a lot as well.
This is probably why I'm struggling as well. On the flip side. Probably this is what I need to do. Like, just be sat at my desk at work, like on the phone.
You're right. I wait there, you'd be on silent for like 10 minutes, and you're just there typing.
Yeah, hold on, I just got to respond to this email real quick.
Yeah, she will sit in silence and wait.
I was going to say, honestly, if it was like just quick 5-minute conversations, like just dotted throughout the day, I wouldn't mind it.
See?
But anything more than that, anything that takes 10, 20 minutes, I'm like,
no, it could
I'm
be
done.
5 minutes dotted throughout the day. That's perfect.
Because that I can handle it, and it makes, it's some sort of structure. As in like, if you're calling me because you just got home or whatever, and you just want to say, yeah, I'm home now, whatever. I'm like, cool, that's fine because this call makes sense.
Yeah.
You're not just calling me to say how are you and try and build like a conversation from there.
No,
like, nah,
it
would
be like what you said, the checking in at the points of the day. Like,
yeah.
Bed
I don't
now.
Think I'd mind that.
Yeah.
I mean, it's funny because like when I was 14, like I would rag it. Like, I wouldn't say like throughout the day, whatever, but like at the end of the day, it would be like, right, let me tap. How was your day? Like, da, 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 da. But.
Yeah, but I'd also never be the one initiating the phone call either.
Oh,
see, that would feel deep. That'd be like, why am I always calling you? Never want to talk to me.
Because if that's all you want to do, call me in it, it's fine,
and
I'll be okay with it.
Sometimes your girl's got to fill you in on her crazy day. Like, you won't believe, this girl at work walked in today and she was getting rude, and I had to say to her, shut up before you, I come and get my manager. And you have to tell your boyfriend these stories.
Nah, I don't want
to
hear that.
That's the night call before you go to bed. You tell him the whole day,
voice
all the little
note.
Things that I hate voice notes. I told you this before, I hate voice notes.
Nah, the voice notes, I hate voice notes. Like,
the two minute limit.
I got a 7-minute voice note one time. I was in Bez's car and I was like, oh my god.
May I ask who this voice note was from?
It's from a random girl.
You got a 2x speed that. Real quick.
Two times
speed. Because you can on WhatsApp you can
do that now.
At the time
I don't think that feature was out yet. I think you just had to play it. I think Bez is in the car and I was just listening to this voice note.
Well done for listening to it.
We were driving, we weren't going anything, nothing was happening. So I was just listening to it. And then I was just like, I can't remember half of what was said. Like, I'm just gonna respond to like the last like bit. Because that's what I remember right now. And just roll with it.
I think your response was literally like 30 seconds or something.
I was like, let me voice note. Because I could have just been like, LOL, okay. but yeah, I was like, let me voice note a response. And I think it was, like something short and like short and sweet.
Honestly, I feel like that's how I would be on a phone call as well. Like, she'd be talking, saying whatever she's saying. And then I respond with like something super short. And then it'd be like, oh. No, I'm like, I'm trying to internalize everything she's saying and trying to figure out a good response. And then at the end of it, I have nothing. I'm just like, okay.
Sometimes Sebez does this to me on the phone, I'm sure. Like, I will tell him a whole story.
I was literally thinking that.
I bet Sebez will do this to me too. I'll tell him the whole story. I'm like, do you hear what I said? And he's like, what do you want me to say? I'm listening. I'm like, every now and then would be good.
Because like, Janine will be, she'll be talking, and she'll stop. And I'm just like, waiting for
the next part of
the story. Yeah, because I'm listening to the, because I know it's not finished yet. So I'm like, waiting. Then
but I'm pausing to make sure he's listening. Mm-hmm.
So, so Cam and Bez, do you two have people, well, Bez, maybe this is a better question for you, but do you have people that you tell these kind of stories to? Like, when things happen in your day at work or whatever, do you have someone that you'll be like, all right, cool, can't wait to tell XYZ about this story?
No, I can't wait to tell this person's story. But
no
like,
way.
I might just tell. Yeah, I'll tell probably you.
Yeah.
I might tell you girls. Mm. I'll tell someone. Yeah, like it might just come up, like sort of thing. But it won't be like as soon as it happens. Like, oh my god, I can't wait to have to tell this person. Like, it might just be like when I'm talking to them.
Yeah,
messaging. I'll be like, oh yeah, oh my god, can't believe this happened today. But like, it won't be like, if Janine's talking to me on the phone and then like she says something and then I'll be like, oh yeah, oh my god, yeah, I was at work today and this happened, sort of thing. Like, it wouldn't. Be my mind at all until that point.
Until it comes up, yeah. What about you, Cam?
I used to when I was like, when I first started working.
Yeah.
Because I was when I was 18, whatever. I had my group chat with my friends, which I'm still in now.
Mm.
Then if something happened that was of note, I would message into the group chat and just like say what happened. But the response that I was getting back was useless. So I was like, this is, there's no point anymore. Because I'm like, this could be the start of a conversation, but my friends were not very good at texting back with something that could
To keep build
upon needs
that.
A confidant. Yeah. Someone, so I was just like, I'm done with it. So your now I just wasn't a good support base.
Yeah, nah. So now I'm just like, nah, I don't care. I'll keep it to myself. Whatever happens, happens.
No.
Yeah, I don't tell anyone about anything that happens. I mean, I'd like to, but no, there's no one. There's
brother?
No one. There's no one
oh
who
my
needs
gosh,
to know.
Brothers sitting here. Where are you? You talk to me if you want. My number. He's like, no, I don't hear your bullshit. What about you, Yas? Do you have anyone that you confide in?
So yeah, I do, and it's kind of similar to kind of Bez's kind of thing.
Yeah,
where like if it comes up, or if I'm like already talking to you, like because like I say, I text throughout the day, or whatever. So if something happens and I'm already texting you, then I might be like, oh, this just happened, bro.
Yeah.
But other than that, yeah, it will have to be a thing of like it would have to come back to me while we're talking. It's not like I would save it. Like, yo, I need to save this to tell this to so-and-so.
All right. So let's say you guys, all three of you, are out, you see someone get run over. You'll just be like, oh my God, that's crazy. And then you'll just walk away. You won't like call someone as soon as you leave the scene.
Right? An ambulance. that'll be who I'll be calling.
I'd probably call Sebez or my best friend.
Sebez, you know CPR?
I ain't got the sirens on my car. What am I going to do?
Oh my gosh. I would literally call Sebez. It is Sebez. I literally tell Sebez everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, I tell Sebez way too much sometimes. Like.
Nah, it's funny because, it's literally, I feel like it's kind of how my family is as well. Like how Cam was saying. We all kind of just do stuff and stuff happens and we just.
No one tells anyone.
Nah. I feel like, it's. Something like that. It's kind of like that. But I mean, our sisters, they talk.
Oh, yeah.
So when something happens with them, they'll share it between each other. But the rest of us, we're just like, whatever.
How many sisters do you... You said there's six. How many sisters are there?
Two sisters.
Oh, okay. And four brothers.
Yep.
Yeah.
So there's... You guys don't like... Well, I guess for them two, they could
they're
be best friends.
They're very close in age. They're like 2 years.
Oh, wow.
And to be fair, me and Cam are close in age as well. But he doesn't like to talk to me.
Nah, don't say that. It's on you, bro. You're the older one. No, but he's the older one. He should be leading the relationship and making things happen.
Do you know what it is? Yeah, do you know what it is? All right. So, I would call this guy.
Yeah.
In my moments of need.
Yeah, sure.
In my moments of need, I'd be like, yo, calling him, like 7 times, 10 times, whatever. No answer. And this is when we used to live together. And I'd come in through the door, go into his room, and I'd be like, yo. Like, he'd just be sat at his computer playing League of Legends or Minecraft or something.
Hold on.
And I'd be like, yo, where's your phone? And it would be like literally next to him, and it would just pick it up and be like, oh, you were calling me.
The thing is that my phone was a problem for me for a good few years, where it was hearing it vibrate would trigger me and I wouldn't feel great. So I turned it off. I turned off the vibrate, so it didn't vibrate, didn't ring or anything. So if you call me, I'm not going to hear it.
I'm not going to see it.
At my phone to see it, and I don't want to look at my phone, because if I look at my phone, I'm not going to feel great.
I understand. The thing is, because we all have phones now, we kind of, people become so accessible. Not to take it too deep, but you know, when it's like in the 90s, you couldn't have done that.
No, this is true. This is true. And like,
recent,
and I definitely understand, because now my phone lives on silent. I've like set it up, apart from a few exceptions.
You have so many cameras on your phone, by the way.
Oh yeah, love that. there's a few, apart from a few exceptions, my phone is on silent. And the exception is my phone is on vibrate.
Okay.
It makes no noises.
Yeah.
So I definitely hear where he's coming from. But at the same time, I have those exceptions because of exactly
you,
that.
You, family.
Yeah, well, I mean, I have that now. But initially, I was just like, the easiest thing for me to do is to just put it on silent. I didn't think to put up any exceptions because no one really called me anyways. And then there'll be the odd time you'll call me 7 times trying to get through to me. And I'm like, I'm not seeing that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
Yeah.
But
you are entitled to your me time and not, you know what I mean? But sometimes your brother needs you.
Trust me. My moments of need.
But nothing you ever called me for was that serious.
It was usually something like...
Turn the oven on.
No, all right. So, I mean, it could be that, but it could also be like, for example, related to food even.
Yeah.
I'd be calling him because I know he's at home. I'd be like, yo, like, who's cooked? What is the food?
Yeah.
Because like, if it's something dead, I'll, on my way home, I'll fly by the takeaway
yeah.
and whatever. And I might even be like, yo, I'll grab you something as well. If you answer the phone.
It's an opportunity.
If you answer the phone, like, I'm coming, like, I'll go to the takeaway, grab you something, whatever. And then I'll get home and then the food will be dead. Then I'll be like, oh my God.
Blame it on him for not answering the phone.
Yeah, like, he
did.
Yo.
He did blame it on me. He'll come and tell me about it.
Like, we could have been eating good.
Ain't it?
Yeah. But I mean, if I had to eat it, you had to eat it too, man.
Oh, of course. Do you ignore me, Sebez?
Nah, I don't ignore you. I always, because unless if my phone's on, because I'm the same, my phone's either on silent or it's on vibrate, but then it will ring when, like, if you call me. So if it's on the loud mode when it rings, then yeah, I'll answer. But I'll never ignore your calls. I always answer them. Then I would tell you I'm busy or I can't just talk right now or something yeah. like. But I wouldn't just air you.
Okay, fair enough. I hope not.
In fact, none of our family answer their phone though. Really?
Yeah, our family's terrible as well with answering their phones. Yeah.
No. Yeah, I hear that snap, snap, snap. But yes, we are way over time.
Oh God, sorry.
But no, it's all good.
It happens like every week.
And like I always say, who's going to beat us up? No one. So yeah, any last things that we want to talk about before we get out of here? Any last questions for our guest before we lose her forever?
Forever. I'll be back in 2 weeks. I'm joking.
I think that's it. I think we can start to wind this down. Actually, why am I lying? We got a whole segment we haven't done. Oh my days, it completely came
surprise?
Out of my mind.
What's going on?
All right, so drum roll. The watch list.
The watch list.
Yes, so this is the segment where we talk about any movies or TV shows that we've been watching recently. It kind of goes past that as well. We kind of talk about books sometimes. We kind of talk about video games as well. Just any kind of like media that we've been enjoying recently. First of all, we'll do us first and we'll come back to you to give you some time to think and whatnot. I see Cam's pulling up his notes. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go for it, my guy.
So what have I been watching? I've been watching both past and present Rick and Morty.
Woo woo.
And I've also been watching both past and present Star Trek Lower Decks, which is banging right now. And then I've been watching She-Hulk every week, which is it's all right. Mm. You know, it's kind of funny, has its moments.
Did you see her twerking in Meg Thee Stallion?
I did. And I was confused. I was like, why is this happening on my screen? And then what else? I think that's it. Just those three things. That's me.
Nice and calm. So me, I've still been watching Bleach. I just passed the point where I stopped, like when I watched it many, many years ago. And I definitely see why I stopped personally. these two don't agree. We've spoken about this many, many times. So it
what
is
episode
what it is.
Are you on? Can I ask that?
I'm on 154.
Have you ever seen Nell's True Form?
I've seen it when you were watching it.
Okay.
So I know it's coming, but I didn't watch it myself. But also, she's so annoying that by the time
bro, actually, she's not. Her, Don DeJaka, and Peche. His name is, they're bants. They are hilarious.
The two, Don DeJaka and Peche, are funny at times. Nell, very annoying. Very, very annoying. I'm like, just stop screaming, stop crying, just stop.
Yeah, she is the annoying one of the three. She's not that annoying. She's okay.
She's top three most annoying people in the show so far.
Who's...
Orihime and Konan.
Okay. As long as Orihime is like number one, then I was like, okay.
Orihime and the Konan stuffed doll. Those two are top two, and then she's third.
I was going to say, you got someone worse than you because Janine watched Bleach until what, like episode
30? I was going to ask
30
you
or something.
I'm sure I did more than that. Give me more credit.
The Bound Arc, she might have stopped at.
To be fair, I would understand that. The way I'm looking at Bleach right now, I'm thinking Soul Society arc, after that, just end it. Like,
how many episodes of Bleach are there? Like 800?
366.
Oh, okay,
yeah,
cool.
Something like that.
Because when it gets to like the Karakura Town arc and stuff like that, it gets like proper. Like, where I'm at now, it's sick.
Well, hopefully I can last that long.
Bro, it's so good. Once everyone's fighting, the captains are fighting, the top tier arc is tech. It's so good.
Hopefully I last that long.
I mean, as far as I'm concerned,
it's good at the point you're at as well.
Agree to disagree.
What's the last major fight that's happened?
The last major fight that's happened was Ichigo versus some Spanish Don.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, well, and then Uryu was fighting some chick with some... it was boring. I wasn't paying that much attention. And now Rukia is about to fight Lieutenant Kayan. And I'm like, oh god, here we go. Because that's I don't like stuff like that. I'm gonna wait and see how they explain it. But generally, I don't like stuff like that. But let's see how they explain it. As in, he's dead, but it's like, no, he's not dead.
Oh yeah, he does come back.
No, he's not dead. This person we thought was dead for years is not dead. I hate it so much.
Like EastEnders.
Now they explain that though. They explain it very quick after. So like, you won't even get into the fight before they explain it.
Okay, good. Well, I'll see what I say now.
Yeah, let me just say, I forgot to say that I also went to the cinema and watched See How They Run.
Oh, yes. So I watched See How They Run as well. I talked about that last time.
Yeah.
You both watched it now as well, innit?
Yeah, I went and watched it as well.
Good stuff. I fell asleep during it.
So. What's See How They Run about?
So it's a murder mystery.
Okay.
So it's a murder mystery set around a play of a murder mystery.
Okay.
So all the characters are either actors or directors or writers who are writing a murder mystery. So it's very meta.
Yeah. Okay. Cool.
So
do you recommend watching it? All of you seen it?
It's fun. It's funny.
Okay.
I fell asleep, but I do want to rewatch it because okay. I was enjoying it up until I did fall asleep. Okay. It wasn't because I was tired. It wasn't because it was boring at first. It was just because I got very cozy in the cinema.
Yeah. It is funny. It is good fun. And because it's like a murder mystery about a murder mystery, it's just,
It's interesting.
Also, been watching Archer as well, the most recent episodes. That's been busting me up.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if any of you lot are watching it, but Cheryl came back in the last episode after being away for a few episodes. And I forgot how funny Cheryl is as a character. Like, just her not being there, like, I didn't notice it massively. But when she was back, I was like, oh shit, you are back. Like, she was killing me. Been enjoying Archer. What else? I'm actually still going. And I think that's it. It's been a quiet 2 weeks, like, watching wise for me. Bez, what about you, man?
So I've been watching Bleach as well. So I'm on episode 290 or something, I think, now.
Are you rewatching it?
Yeah, rewatching it. Then I watched, I went to cinema and watched See How They Run, and then I watched a new movie called Smile. I went to cinema yesterday and watched that.
How Smile? I've seen adverts for everyone. There's been people in stages smiling for hours.
I saw that tweet just after I watched the film. It's so creepy because the film is really good.
Okay.
Very creepy.
Okay.
It's not really, it's not scary, it's just very creepy.
Okay.
It's a good film. It's worth watching. Don't know about, if you can wait to watch it when it's online or on TV somewhere. I would say, but when it is, I'd say definitely worth watching.
Okay.
It's good. Watched Jeffrey Dahmer, the series, which was, that was good. Interesting. And then I think that's about it, really.
Nice, quiet all around, pretty much then. We've all been busy having... It's funny, because we've all been off work, and we all ain't been watching stuff.
So. I've just been watching Bleach a lot, though, I feel like.
Okay, so me and Cam been off work, and we've been watching stuff. Quite good.
I think I just burnt out off of... Because last episode, I said, seven or eight things I was watching.
So I'm the only one out here hustling. So I've been off work and I've been hustling. Too busy making TikTok videos. That's not even a joke. I do have a TikTok video that's doing a lot right now. So go check it out at Yell's Music on TikTok. So Mr. Creator.
Oh yes, me.
Is there anything that you've seen recently? It doesn't even have to be like that. We do the last 2 weeks because obviously we're here, but you can just do anything.
I'll do my last couple of weeks because that's kind of how far back my memory goes at the moment.
That's fair enough.
But I'll say I've been watching Rick and Morty as well. I like the new episodes.
Mm.
I've been watching something called Pantheon. Have you heard of Pantheon?
No. What's
it's a cartoon as well. It's like an adult cartoon where it's about this girl who... her dad dies, and it's something to do with basically they put your human conscious into the internet or something like that. So she starts getting messages from this random account. Have you heard of it?
I think I saw it on... Is it on Netflix?
I think it was, and it's like a picture of a girl's face to the side. I think it was on Netflix.
Yeah, I think you might have told me about it, or was it, I think we saw it somewhere.
Yeah, sounds like Cyberpunk.
Yeah,
it does actually. Yeah,
sounds like what?
Cyberpunk, the game.
Is that what that's about as well?
Basically,
there's loads
of
stuff coming with this. You know, this consciousness, the internet, it's a bit scary. But yeah, I watched Dharma as well. I wasn't sure if I was going to mention it or not. I've seen a lot of backlash on the internet about how many times you're gonna revive the Dharma story. So yeah, like, what do you think about Dharma, Sibes?
It was nuts. Like, it was crazy. I don't know if you've seen it advertised or anything like that.
I've seen people talking about it on Twitter, and a friend of mine told me about one of the victims. So yeah, I saw that. I don't really know like the full story of I did see a lot of the backlash about why we
shouldn't watch it. Are you like kind of like, not watching it for that reason?
I just didn't hear about it, and like I say, I've been making TikTok videos.
Oh yeah, I watched Blonde today as well. I don't know if you've seen that come up on.
I saw it come up, but I
wouldn't recommend.
No,
sorry,
not good.
No, it's all right, but it's the fact that it's not factual. It's like, what's the point in watching made up Marilyn Monroe story? I also watched The Kardashians recently. That's another thing. I don't know. Obviously, you guys wouldn't watch that, but I watched The Kardashians. Books. What books would I recommend? I recommend You Can Heal Your Life by Louise Hay. That's a very good book. I also recommend anything by Dr. Joe Dispenza. He's a really good writer.
Jeez, okay.
Do you know Dr. Joe Dispenza?
I don't, but he sounds very...
He's amazing.
PhD and everything.
No, he's amazing. But yeah, what else would I recommend? I read a lot of, like, again, like you lot, I read Tabez's mangas that you don't mind giving to me every now and then, borrowing me. And I read a lot of health books, healing books, metaphysical books, self-help books, history books. I like your little collection of, like, African history books. But yeah, that's my... little watch list.
Love that.
I've been watching As Told by Ginger as well. Rewatching that.
Oh wow.
Do you not remember that?
Nah.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, I've been rewatching that, but yeah, that's it.
Right, fair enough. So I think it's more or less about time that we get out of here.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you for coming. Thank you for coming.
Ben promised me a bowl of red Skittles, which never appeared.
You didn't ask for them.
I'm joking.
I offered.
Damn, Red Skittles didn't materialize.
No, it was amazing. Thank you, honestly.
No, yeah, thank you for coming, obviously, and welcome back at any time. But yeah, make sure you follow Janinne. That's at Janinne the Creator. We spelled it enough times for you, so go back and hear it again.
If you want tattoos.
Yeah, for all your tattoo content, make sure you follow me at Yells Music for all your good music content. Bez and Cam, don't follow them. Their accounts are dead.
Come on. Gotta find me on YouTube and Twitch at Fovia.
Yeah, at Fovia on YouTube and Twitch for all your gaming content. Oh. What are you playing at the moment again? Are you still playing that?
Yeah, game? Omega Strikers, League of Legends, Overwatch are my three right now.
Yeah, and Bez, what content are you giving them?
I don't tweet. I don't post.
Posting TikTok videos of you getting a pump in.
Yeah. Pump.
Yeah, when Yell starts dropping me the music, I'm gonna start doing all them gym videos with his songs on TikTok.
Nah, Bez runs our Five Letter Podcast social media. So if you want to get at Bez, obviously hit out the Five Letter Podcast social media at Five Letters Podcast on basically anything: TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. Is that it? That's it. Yeah. So yeah, hit us up. Let us know what you're thinking. Let us know if you have a tattoo. Let us know if you want a tattoo. Any designs that you got your eyes on. Maybe Janinne can get it done for you. Wink, wink. Okay, and just before we get out of here, we got one more song for you. This one's Russ Millions, Krept and Konan, the track and title, Pisces.
Millions, I've been charting for ages. Bubba Millie, up in her playlist. Killing it, give her wood, she can't take it. Dicking it, bust my nut, let her taste it. Similar, tender touch, nothing basic. Pickle it, pick and then make her shake it. Climax, cool, so left her leg shaking. Figure eight, long my legs, I can't break it. I ain't got no manners, them man yap yap ain't causing damage. Rid on back, watch him lose his balance. My girl's bougie, but a man's a savage. Face deep, but I don't mind a challenge. Reflex got an amazing talent. Deeper, pull him across
my... The Five Letters Podcast.